Hi, and welcome back to the channel. Managing a Unix-like operating system is different. It's not like Windows. You don't just double-click something or right-click here or look at an event viewer. It's completely different. It's just using a command line. And today, I'm just going to show you some of the commands that I use when trying to diagnose or figure out something on my FreeBSD host. Most of these commands work on Linux or any other variant that you can think of. Most of them even work on Solaris, HP UX. Doesn't matter. If it's a Unix-like operating system, most of them will have these commands. So let's just jump into it and let's see how we go on, shall we? So as you can see, we have my terminal here. So the first command that I use on a daily basis is tail, which allows me to look at logs. I find this extremely useful just to see what's going on the logs. So tail minus F for file, and then whichever log you want to look at. And in this case, there we go. So that's this server is not running a mail server, but you get the point. So anything that logs to a file in var log, I can tail it just to see what's happening. So if I go into var log and look at all the logs that are there, let's try a different one, shall we? Let's look at, okay, there's a good one. So if we go into Nginx, so there's the logs from the last video. So when we set up Nginx and PHP. So if I tailed access.log, there we go. You'll see all of the hits that when I was showing you how to set up that. absolutely vital that you can monitor logs in this manner. I can't describe to you just how helpful this is. Okay, so the next command that I use quite regularly is grep to see what's inside of a file. Grep, so on FreeBSD I can issue a which grep and it will tell me where it is. So user bin grep, and if I grep for a string, for instance, I'm in here and I want to check out who's looked at the test.php page. If I do grep test.php, and that was the 10 access file, it will show me the line. So there we go. Very useful for diagnosing what's going on or finding something in a configuration file. Again, I use this on a daily basis, I would say. Extremely helpful command. Okay, so the next one would be, let's just change directory and clear screen. We don't need to see that. The next command that I like to use is top, which shows me a list of all the running PIDs and services and processes that are running on the host. It also shows me my load average shows me the memory that's in use, what I've got free. This is very helpful as well. So you'll see PHP FPM from the previous video running there. It tells me how much memory is being used by it, which is what, 158 meg. You can see Nginx there using 21 meg. That's another extremely useful command just to see what's going on. SSHD there, which allows me to log in. Now I'll get into some of the real nitty-gritty commands that are very useful, I find, on FreeBSD especially. And they are pretty helpful from a standpoint of installing software and managing and rebooting. You know, sometimes it's not evident how you do these things, But I'll show you how to do that anyway. So let's go back to our terminal here. So the first command that I would use here would be package, as I showed you on the other one before. Package is what I use to install software, uninstall software, update software. So for instance, I can go package update, and it will check the repository and update stuff if there's any updates. I don't expect there to be any on this one, purely and simply because it's quite a new instance of FreeBSD. So if I wanted to install a piece of software like a text editor called Nano, package install Nano. There it is. Install it. Job done. And I can use Nano to have a look at files. There we go. Nano. Interestingly, very similar to my favourite one, which is Pico. In fact, I wouldn't be surprised if it's actually the same file. Oh no, Nano's a GNU, GNU application. Okay, so we've got our diagnostic tools there. So the other thing that is very helpful is what is running on startup. So if we go into the etc directory, you'll see a file there called rc.conf. Now this is specific to FreeBSD and BSD variants, not all of them, some of them. This just lists the services that start on boot up and sets a few key configuration components, for instance, the host name, which keyboard you're using, whether it's on DHCP or any networking stuff. And as you can see, I set Nginx and PHP running. Just using a text editor of your choice, Nano, Pico, EE, even Vi or Vim, if that's your choice. Not for me, I'm afraid. Don't particularly like those ones. So the next couple of commands we have here, we have the shutdown command, which you'll need to run as root. If I was to run that as as a standard user, it won't like it. So I'm going to shut down ISR now. So that tells it to reboot. Permission denied. If I do that as root, bye bye for now. So what you'll see is you have full flexibility to literally do anything you like. So the other thing that goes hand in hand with that one is instead of minus R, minus H, which turns off the computer, which is always quite handy. There are genuinely loads and loads of commands, which I'm not going to get into today. The only other ones that I would suggest being used are things like make build world, which is very FreeBSD specific again, which will update the running system from source. You can do it using the binary FreeBSD update tool. I don't genuinely like to use them. I don't generally like to use FreeBSD update. I like to do it from source, which means nice, fresh running operating system, which is generally checked out from Git, a Git repository. Again, just all out helpful tools. Most problems I've found with FreeBSD can be solved by just updating and getting yourself onto the latest running version of the OS and a fresh kernel. Yeah, so that's about that for that one. Again, hopefully you found this video useful. If you have, give it a like and a thumbs up, and I'll see you in the next one. Thanks very much. Bye.